Hello, this is Terry Leek, Pastor Leek's wife here in Allen, Texas. And this is the front of our storefront here. And then we walk over here and have nice lettering on our window and the door as well. And I'll take you inside here and show you how things are looking. This is our water fountain here, and we have a nice little entryway done here. And a beautiful wall decoration here that Brother Leek and our son Chris were able to put together. And please excuse the chairs. They're kind of all over the place as we've been trying to reset things up from the way that they're 6 feet out. And here's my husband in the pulpit here. And I think he's going to give you an update about how things are going in Allen, Texas. Oh, yes. How could I forget? We have this set up here as our missions wall. And we're working on getting some prayer letters put into these sign holders. Got one up there right now. And we're excited about what God's going to do with the mission work here in Allen, Texas, and even through Harvest Baptist Church as well.
And the banner.
So we've got a nice banner on the wall there. And
all
our
right.
Flags and piano. And here's Brother Leek.
Well, good morning, Lighthouse Baptist Church in Laverne, California. This is Brother J.D. Leek, missionary church planter to Allen, Texas. So thrilled to come to you from the pulpit at Harvest Baptist Church here in Allen. And I got an email just a little while ago, Brother Dunlap had asked for me to make a video, kind of a short video update slash presentation for each of you there in Laverne that are unable to attend the services. I understand that's a challenge around our nation right now. And so I would like to just do that. I asked my wife to kind of walk you in and kind of let you see the beautiful place that God has so graciously given us to meet in. And so let me just kind of give you a little bit of a recap. I know that our next prayer letter is scheduled to come out about the first part of May. And so I know that maybe you'll be able to go back to church by then, maybe not. I don't know. I know it's a case-by-case situation around the country. Fortunately for us, our governor from day one has declared that churches are exempt, so we've not broken any laws. We have been able to assemble. We've not stopped services, not one time. We did have to move our services to our home while we were in the process of remodeling this place, just because the normal meeting place at the city had to close down. And then last week, it's been quite a battle, quite a challenge, but we were able to obtain a temporary occupancy permit on last Friday, a week ago today. And they were kind of pushing on us about some things that we thought was kind of unfair. But nonetheless, they were going to let us meet with 30 being our temporary number. And we really needed to try to get to 50 or 49, stay right under 50. And we've requested that, and we've kind of gone back and forth. Well, I got good news on that. Here in just a little while, the chief building inspector is going to come by. They have issued us our permanent occupancy permit for 49 persons. And what a blessing that is. To get to that number will be a miracle in itself, but we're so excited. So as you've seen, just by way of this little video, you've seen what a beautiful place that God has given us. If you saw the pictures on our last prayer letter, you saw some of the before pictures. On our next prayer letter, we'll have, of course, more detailed pictures of the before and after. What a miracle. This place was a hair salon. It was nasty. And now it's a church. Amen. We had church in here last Sunday. We had 11 with one first-time visitor. We're so excited about that. I had received an email from Brother Randolph the other day, just following up, probably just checking on missionaries, and just wanted to let us know that y'all are praying for us, and then ask if there was any prayer requests. And I just shared with him just the details of what kind of things that we've been experiencing, just so you know how to pray for us. And so we originally, we had some men from Independent Baptist Builders come and look at this place prior and say, okay, this is what it's going to cost material-wise to basically remodel this place and make it usable church space. And the budget was $4,800. We needed $4,800 to just do everything that's been done, everything that you see here. And the men came and they labored at no charge to us. We just paid for the material. And so we went to work. We shared that with some folks. Out of that $4,800 budget, we only raised $3,800. Now, we we had a couple of special love offerings just from preaching and so forth, and I put every dime of that into this to make sure we had the money to go forward, because it's vital. If we don't go forward at this stage in it, especially with a global pandemic taking place, which we had no idea that was going to happen just days after all of this was kind of set in motion, and so it was like we had to make that decision to go forward. Otherwise, we may not even be here now. So we're just trying to thank the Lord for that. As many of you that have ever been in a building project, it's a learning process. A lot of times you run into this problem and that problem, and oh no, we didn't know this. And that's kind of how it's been for us. It's been a great learning curve. We ended up, and to date, as of our email earlier this week, we were at $13,000 is how much we've spent on this. And keep in mind, only $3,800 of that was given towards the great need. But as this has gone forward, we're closer now to the $14,000 mark, and we've spent every dime we had. We did, God blessed us with a stimulus check, but we poured every dime of that back into here, not only to finish this project, but to decorate the right way. As you see, it's a beautiful place. We still need new chairs, and you pray for us about that, but just to do it right, I want to open the doors and go forward. So that's what we've spent. And the reason I share that is just so that you can pray for us, because we put ourselves in a position we don't normally do. We put the church first this time, even above our own family needs, and that's fine. We're not sad. We don't have a sad story. We're excited that God let us do it. I'm glad it was there, nonetheless, we just need some miracles, and that's all I'm going to say about that. And pray for us. We have a sign that will be on the building hopefully next week. It's already been paid for, but the city has to issue a permit for that. They're dragging their feet about that, as you can imagine. But it's a miracle they did in the midst of all of this, in the midst of a global pandemic. God allowed Harvest Baptist Church to go forward and to get into this place. And I'm so thrilled, and excuse me, I'm overwhelmed, because I'm still standing in a place that it's just a miracle. If you just had seen the fact that the steps that God has brought us through, we were running close to the mid-20s during all this, and then we went right back down to 9, and last week we had 11, and you know, we believe that God's going to rebuild, but man, we just kept going forward, and that's what we're going to do. We're not stopping. I'm not live streaming. I don't do any of that. I'm not against the guys that do. We're just old-fashioned. I just open up the Bible, and I preach, because we're called to assemble. And that's what we're trying to do here in Allen, Texas, to reach the lost. And you pray that God would raise up a church for His glory and His honor in this place. It's a miracle. I mean, it's a miracle that we're even able to meet in the midst of all that's going on, when most of our nation has come to a screeching halt, if you will. They've stopped, and many have not been able to assemble, and yet we are here, and we've been able to assemble. We give God the glory for that. And so pray for us. I want to say this about Lighthouse Baptist Church in Laverne. I want to say thank you. Thank you, Brother Dunlop. Thank you for the leadership. Thank you for the membership. Thank you for, first of all, giving us the opportunity to come out there and to share our burden and to preach to you last year. And then to take that to the next step and to begin to pray for us, and then to take us on for support and to help us. And then time and again, you've given to our need, and you've helped us, and you've given special love offerings along the way. And I just want to say thank you. My family and I are humbled and thankful. I wish more people would see the importance of having a church in every city in America. But we're here because of churches and people just like you. We don't want to take that for granted. We say thank you, thank you, thank you. Obviously, the greatest need we have is prayer. We need wisdom on how to reach this city for Christ. We need wisdom on how to just stand when everyone seems to be wanting to throw in the towel. And so many don't even, we got people that are scared to come to church because the media has created a massive panic in our society. But yet, God's called us to assemble, and we're thankful. And we want to say thank you again for all of your prayers, your love, your support. And I want to ask you, if God lays it on your heart, say a time of special prayer for my family and I, that God will meet our needs as we've tried to put Him first. We've tried to put the church first, because I feel like now more than ever is the time that everything must be laid on the line. I believe our Lord is soon to return, and we better do what we can while we can before they take away our rights to even assemble as a church. Again, this is Brother J.D. Leake, Harvest Baptist Church your church planter, your missionary to the city of Allen, Texas, saying thank you, and please continue to hold the ropes as we go forward for the cause of Christ. May God richly bless you for your faithfulness, for your sacrifice, your love, your prayers, and your support. God bless you.